Welcome to the Spicks and Specks Naughties Special, the music quiz show that answers the age-old question, what are you going to do with all that junk inside your trunk? Joining me as always are our two team captains, the man whose milkshake brings all the boys to the yard, although the same can't be said for his chicken tikka masala, Alan Bro. And I ain't saying she's a gold digger, but she does have a copy of Modern Prospector on her bedside table, Miff Warhurst. Alan's first guest tonight is the lead singer of Killing Heidi, who had the number one single in the country on her 17th birthday. So it was kind of hard to feign excitement when she got a Brash's gift voucher from her auntie. Please welcome Ella Hooper. Alan's second team member tonight is a comedian who cried when he saw Bardot in concert. So did his parents, mainly because they had to pay for the tickets and accompany him. Please welcome Joel Creasy. Miss First Guest Tonight had an international hit with Are You Gonna Be My Girl, which sold 3 million copies and was on an iPod ad, but to anyone under 10 will always be the song in the movie Flushed Away when Roddy the Rat falls down the toilet. Would you please welcome Nick Sester? Miss Final Guest Tonight is a comedian who told us she watched the Britney Spears movie Crossroads whilst drunk and thus became the only person in history to give it a good review. Would you please welcome Sarah Pendle? Tonight is all about music from the 2000s. It's the decade that brought sexy back. Unfortunately, my beard has scared it away again. And look, before we get into the music of the 2000s, I'm going to ask everyone just quickly, how did you celebrate the millennium? Do you remember what you were doing when it became 2000?
I do. I remember. I thought the Y2K thing was going to be a thing.
Mm. Yeah. Yes.
So everybody was going out to watch fireworks and stuff, and I thought you fools are going to die after midnight.
Right.
And I went to bed, and I was feeling really smug. I was like, I'm going to survive this apocalypse. And I was really disappointed. Everything was fine.
Nick, what were you doing?
I seem to remember waiting an extraordinary amount of time for a taxi to get home.
That's your only memory of that night?
Pretty much.
How are your memories generally of the 2000s?
Say that again. It's probably the decade in which I remember the least.
You were having the most fun?
Yeah.
Oh, mine was excellent. I went to a dance party called Welcome 2000 that was down in Melbourne at the Docklands, and I think I rung in the new year with my head in a wheelie bin.
Wow.
Al?
I was at the Auckland Domain in New Zealand, and the Auckland Hospital's nearby and had a big digital clock on it, and at 11:59, me and my friend Murray watched it in a similar way to go, well, when it clicks over, if that goes out, then we're all in the shit.
Ella, how did you see in the year 2000?
I was also at the Domain, but it was Sydney Domain, and it was the big New Year's Eve 2000 gig, and that was probably our first banger year. So I guess that was my year, which means also, very much like Nick, I don't remember much since then.
You don't remember we hooked up during that period?
I was gonna ask, but I felt rude.
Yeah. And finally,
Joel. Have a love child.
It's me.
It's all coming back.
And finally, Joel.
I was at the Applecross Tennis Club in Perth. I was 9. And I was there with my best friend, Ashley, and her family and my family. And we're still best friends. Ashley now has a girlfriend, and I've had many, many, many boyfriends. And at midnight, my mum, who'd had, like, 58 bottles of Drow Adwan, said to Ashley, like, you guys should kiss. It's the millennium. You should kiss. So we had a kiss, and we went, oh, yeah, that's not for us.
In reference to the 2000s, Alan and Miff and I are wearing the same clothes we wore on an episode of Spicks and Specks during the 2000s. In fact, we have the photo here to prove it.
Oh!
What are we doing to Miff?
I know! Put a hashtag Me Too on that and it's all over.
No chance that we'd be allowed to do that now.
And I love it.
That looks like a sitcom about two guys and they don't know which one's fathered the child.
Alan and Miff are going to choose one topic between them, but any team can answer the questions. Your choices tonight are 2000s AD, 2000s BC, 2000 CDs, and 2000 BGs.
Wow.
I mean, the 2000s AD.
Yeah, let's have 2000s
AD. Let's go with 2000s AD. All right, everyone on your buzzers. Let's play Spicks and Specks. Your first question for 1 point. Which member of Destiny's Child was the first to feature on an Australian number one single? Alan's side, yes.
Kelly Rowland.
Yes, it was Kelly Rowland. Correct answer. The song was Dilemma. It was a duet with Nelly.
Oh, great song. Right. Great song.
By the way, in that song, the Kelly Rowland song, there is an amazing 2000s moment where she seems to send a sexy message to Nelly.
Yes.
But she appears to send it on Excel spreadsheet.
Oh, nice tips.
Nice work.
What? What the hell?
That's great.
How did anyone send sexy messages on Excel spreadsheet?
As someone that suffers from OCD, I'm very turned on. Like, any sort of spreadsheet's going to get me going.
So basically, you sending a sexy message go, oh, I'm going to tell you what I'm going to do to you tonight. Open new workbook. Yeah. Add columns to Excel. All right, second question. This 2006 viral film clip won a Grammy Award for Best Short Form Music Video and a YouTube Award for Most Creative. For 2 points, name the band and the song. Midside, yes.
Yep.
Okay,
Go, Here
yep.
It Goes.
Yep. Okay, Go, Here It Goes Again. Yes.
Yeah. I know stuff.
You do know
you
stuff.
I know stuff.
You know stuff.
That clip, by the way, was shot in one take. Looks like it was filmed at a local gym with a budget of $25, and the choreography was so difficult, out of 21 attempts, they only succeeded 3 times. Wow. But it's been viewed 50 million times, and the group copped 4 suspensions from Fitness First for not bringing a towel. We don't have footage of the 18 failed attempts, but we can only assume they look like this. For 3 points. Have a look at these artists who all went solo in the 2000s.
Oh, shit.
Oh, okay.
Do we need to talk about their other bands that they were in?
No, no, no. You have to guess what the rest of the question was going to be now.
Pharrell was in NERD. That is
Gwen Stefani.
Gwen Stefani, no, and she was in No Doubt. And Will.i.am was in
Black Eyed Peas.
3 points out of three. Absolutely correct. Yes, on the left is Will.i.am, who, when he dies, will have the tombstone Will I Was. Gwen Stefani was in No Doubt. She went solo in 2004. The band changed their name to Heaps of Doubt. And Pharrell was in NERD. Apparently, before he got into music, he was fired by 3 different McDonald's stores, which was kind of a good thing because it meant he didn't have to wear a stupid hat to work. All right, next question. Listen to these popular songs from the 2000s. Wait till the end for 4 points. Name the tracks you hear being sampled.
Ooh.
Oh. I gotta testify. Come up in the spot looking extra fly. For the day I die, I'ma touch the sky. Oh, ask please somebody help me.
Yeah. One more.
It was 1989.
Oh. Yes, go on, go on.
Money.
Oh, no, do you know what? I'm not going to give you that one, but I'll let the other team have a shot in a second. Go, the other three.
Curtis Mayfield's. Move On Up.
Move On Up by Curtis Mayfield, yes. Was in the Kanye West featuring Lupe Fiasco song Touch the Sky.
That's right, and that last one.
Tainted Love. And then Sweet Home Alabama.
Tainted Love was in the Rihanna song S.O.S. But Sweet Home Alabama pops up later in the song, but it wasn't the sample that was being used in that clip. So I'm going to throw it over to these guys if you know the other two.
Werewolves of London.
Werewolves of London was the sample that is in that particular bit of the song. And the first one?
Gimme, Gimme, Gimme.
Gimme, Gimme, Gimme is the one I was looking for. Well done, Alan, yes. Finally, Australian Idol ran from 2003 to 2009.
Whoa.
And kickstarted the career of many Australian singers. For 5 points, I need the 5 Idol contestants to win music arias. Yes.
Guy Sebastian's definitely won an aria.
Guy Sebastian is one.
Jessica Mowboy's definitely won an aria. Yep. What's the one that's gone all hipster and alternative? What's his name?
Matt Corby
is one of them, yes.
That has exhausted my knowledge now about Australian Idol.
Okay, shall I ask the other team? You've got 3 out of the 5.
I've got this, Miff, don't worry.
You got it?
I have no idea.
Anthony Kalia?
Yes, Anthony Kalia is another one.
Surely Nolsey won an aria for something. Yeah. He didn't win Idol, but surely he won an aria.
Shannon Knoll did not win an aria for anything.
What?
The other person I was looking for was...
Oh, I've had an idea.
Go.
Ricky Lee?
No. Oh. What? Damien Leith was the other person
yes.
I was looking for.
Yes.
Damien Leith?
For one of his adult contemporary albums.
Yes, the only Idol contestants to win music arias were Guy Sebastian, Jess Mowboy, Matt Corby, Damien Leith and Anthony Kalia. How did Shannon Noel feel about that? What about me?
Yes.
Joel, now from what I understand, you were quite affected by Australian Idol.
I loved Australian Idol. Mm-hmm. I was there when Cosima DeVito got the nodules. when Ricky Lee was voted out seventh in season two,
yep.
I didn't go to school the next day because I couldn't stop crying.
All right, at the end of the first round, Alan, Ella, Joel are on 6 points. Miff, Nick, Sarah in front, 8 points. Teams have to identify the songs being played live in the studio. Tonight, your songs will be played by some Nokia mobile phones. Yes, we have 5 2000-era mobile phones, each one with a different annoying ringtone that was a popular song at the time.
Oh, my God.
I'm going to phone each one. You need to buzz in if you think you can name the song. All right.
Well, I'm getting a Crazy Frog vibe.
Yeah, it's coming.
Yeah.
All right, hands on your buzzers.
Oh.
Dialing the first one now. Yes.
It's Coldplay.
Yes.
Viva La Vida.
Viva La Vida. Yeah, that's what I'm looking for. Yes, well done.
It's not often that a ringtone can sound better than the original song.
Well, I was about to say, I'm so used to this game, having a band over here, that I was literally about to go, all right, phones, song. all right, here's the second one. There we go, dialing. Ho, ho.
Am I not pretty enough?
Yes, Casey yeah! Chambers. Oh, correct.
Wow. Amazing. Great song.
Right, here we go. Song three. There it is. Yes.
It's the postal service.
Yes.
Such Great Heights.
Such Great Heights by the postal service.
Well done.
Oh, my God. I love that record as well.
Yes. Okay, here we go. Dialing up the next one.
Crazy
by Gnarls Barkley.
Wow.
Yes, correct.
Some poor drug dealer's missing all his burner phones over there. Very quiet night at work.
And yet Adam's got all of their numbers.
Final song.
I'm going out on a limb and saying it wasn't a hit.
Listen to the chorus, listen to the chorus.
Oh, is that me? Is that me?
Oh, hang on, this buzzer went off first, yes.
It is, it's Jet. Rollover DJ?
It's Rollover DJ by Jet.
You were wasted for most of this decade. Yeah. So I didn't believe you.
No, we mean it.
I sang that last night too.
To be fair.
I'm not sure which line I enjoyed more. You saying, was that me? Or Alan saying, I'm going to go out on a limb and say it wasn't a hit. At the end of that round, the scores are Alan, Ella, Joel on 9 points. Miff, Nick, Sarah just in front, 10 points. I'm going to ask each team a question and give them three possible answers. All you have to do is tell me which one you think is true. Myth, here is your question. In 2003, this song... Hey Ya by Outkast was tested on both human listeners on the radio and a computer program called Hit Song Science to determine if it was going to be a hit. The outcome of that test was A, the computer program deemed the song a hit but the human listeners hated it, B, the computer program deemed the song a flop but the human listeners rated it a hit, or C, both the computer program and the human listeners deemed the song a flop.
Gosh, I would have said none of those because it's such a genius song.
I remember reading a review at the time, actually, which said, if you don't like this song, you do not like music.
Absolutely. I'm a human being and I loved it. That's the only thing I can go from. So I
put our faith in humanity and go with that
one. Yeah, and say that the computer was wrong because that is one of the best songs of all time.
So you're saying the computer thought the song was a flop but the humans liked it?
Yes.
The correct answer is... A, the computer liked it, but the humans didn't.
No!
Taken away your faith in humanity.
It was gone anyway.
The true, the people that first heard the song didn't think it was going to be a hit, but this computer predicted that it would be.
Who are they? I need to know their addresses and I want to go and visit them individually.
Apparently what happened was it was too different to other songs at the time and radio listeners weren't getting their heads around it. Yeah. So what the radio stations did was they programmed it between two well-known songs on either side of it and people then gradually got used to it and then it started to become a hit.
I was in America a lot when this song broke and I remember it was like ridiculous.
Yeah, it was so big that because it had the line in it, shake it like a Polaroid picture, sales of Polaroids started to increase off the back of the song.
Yeah. They had to release an official statement saying that that does not,
do not
enhance.
Yes,
I've actually got the quote. I checked it out. Polaroid released a statement in 2004 that said, and I quote, rapid movement during development can cause portions of the film to separate prematurely and cause blobs in the picture.
Oh.
Do not shake Polaroid pictures. Alan, this is your fact slash question. In a 2019 Facebook post, Ray Thistlethwaite, the lead singer of Aussie band Thirsty Merc, said in a reference to his 2005 hit song In the Summertime,
take me back to the sweet times, the hot nights, everything is gonna be alright in the summertime.
Now, which of these three things did Ray say about that song? And I'm just going to point out I'm reading the family-friendly alternatives. A, In the Summertime to me was just a filler, a written in 5 minutes album track, and it's made me a shedload of cash. Life's fudging great, huh? B, I regret everything about In the Summertime. I was a fudging talented jazz muso and I sold out with that song. Everything clever about it was lost in production. Or C, was I trying to write a hit? Fudge, yeah, I was. I was fudging trying to write a hit. I wanted it to get on the fudging radio. I wanted it to get played like a fudging mother fudger.
Mother fudging shouldn't be a thing, should it?
It actually sounds worse than what it's trying to do.
It does, doesn't it? I fudge that mother.
Whoa!
Well, they've all kind of got the same vibe. A seems very... No?
Oh, do you...
I believe...
Do you know him?
Well, we have been touring together a lot recently.
Did you fudge him?
Yeah.
I haven't fudged everyone. No, I think it's C because he's a very talented musician and he knows he is and he is and he doesn't bow to that stupid Australian pretense of, you know, tall poppy syndrome and being, oh, no, man, you know, I just... three chords and the truth, it just fell out of me. Ray's actually studied music and he's good at music and he did mean to write that as a hit, so it's C.
Well...
I think...
I'm scared to argue. C.
The correct answer is... C. Oh. Always trying to write a hit?
I mean, it's weird for me because we had a success very quickly, which is unusual.
Yeah.
And that put an enormous amount of pressure on me to attempt to recreate that.
Yeah.
I very quickly learned that the moment that you try to do that is the moment that it will elude you.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
You have
no
chance. So, yeah, I tried. And as Alan can attest to, it did not.
I would back that up. The more you try, the harder it gets. So I think when you forget
who's listening... Exactly, because when it happened, you weren't trying.
And Not at all.
It's a magical moment when lightning strikes inexplicably.
Did you know when you wrote, say, Mascara or We're or Are You Gonna Be My Girl, did you have a feeling, oh, this is gonna take off?
Yeah, there was something special about that song that was obvious from from the beginning, I guess, yeah.
Right. No, I remember one week I was seeing you guys for, like, $4 at the
Duke of Windsor.
The Duke of Windsor. Yeah. And it was just like, yeah, this band's really cool. There's something going on here. And it was literally only months later.
Yeah, and it was amazing. And within a couple of weeks, you were global.
Yeah, our first ever tour was with the Rolling Stones. Like, I'd forgotten about that, actually, but I did an interview this morning and I was quizzed on those early initial stages and... Yeah, I genuinely don't remember a lot about this particular decade, but it's true.
Which is massive to forget touring with the Rolling Stones, though.
Did you ever do any gigs with Bardo?
It's never too late, mate. It's never too late.
You did tour with Metallica, though. What would they like to tour with?
The few things that I do remember, it's impossible for me to talk about because they are very much X-rated, I suppose.
Wow. Ooh.
Right.
As soon as someone says a thing like that, my brain, I already think, what's the filthiest thing that Metallica could have done? I felt like the Human Centipede in my head.
All right, at the end of that round, the scores are Alan, Ella, Joel, 10 points. Miff, Nick, Sarah, also 10 points. Our next game tonight is called Tuba Styling. Now, the 2000s saw the advent of YouTube, and along with that, the comment section, where anyone and everyone could tell you exactly what they thought of your upload. And hey, who doesn't want to hear the opinion of someone called Arsehat99?
Oh, that's me!
I'm going to read comments left by viewers on YouTube. Teams have to identify the noughties video clip they are referring to. Each team will be given 3 clues that get progressively easier. If you guess correctly on the first one, you'll receive the maximum 3 points, then 2, then 1. Miff, your team's first. Here is your first YouTube comment. There is no special effect. In fact, person's name really can fly.
Kanye West had touched the sky.
Oh, nice one. Yeah. At the end, he goes up into the clouds. I think that's a really good call.
Is that your first guess?
Yes.
It is not. That is not. So I'm going to give you another clue. Here's another comment left after that video. The guy trained as a dancer, he'd probably been waiting for this his whole life.
Oh, my God, it's Fatboy Slim. He can go this.
Oh, Christopher Walken. Christopher Walken is a professional.
Yeah, he does.
You're right, you're absolutely right.
Oh, my God.
But I need the name of the song.
Weapon of Choice.
Weapon of Choice, Fatboy Slim. Yes, 2 points. The video in question looked like this.
It's a great music video.
It really is. I forgot about this video.
Yes.
All right, Alan, the next one's for your team. Here's your first comment, and it's referring to the likes. This is how many times people have tried to learn this choreography and failed miserably.
Single Ladies.
But when was that?
2009, maybe? Yeah, I think it was in that period.
Okay, is that what you're going to go with?
Single Ladies.
Let's try Single Ladies.
Yeah.
Absolutely correct. Oh, it is Single Ladies. Wow. The other clues were LMAO. Anyone remember when Kanye interrupted Taylor for this video?
Oh.
And then the final comment was this. And of course, the video looked like this.
Like the whole thing.
Yes.
She's got a bright future.
I think she'll go far.
She's going to be okay.
I think she is going to be okay.
According to choreographer Frank Gatson Jr., the Single Ladies dance was designed to have some moves in it that your grandmother could do.
Which
that,
one?
It's the one halfway through when Beyonce spits on a hanky and then rubs someone's face. The amazing thing about that dance is that Miff and Alan and I did that dance when we did Spicks and Specks live on tour.
We did.
And it is one of those ones that sticks in your head. If I played the music, do you reckon you guys could remember the moves right now?
Oh, yeah!
So if we face this way and we get ready for this bit...
Yes. It's becoming a bit Human Centipede, actually.
Do it now! All the single centipedes, it's not right.
All right, well, OK, hit the music, let's see if we can remember. Okay. Wow, well, excellent work. All right, Miff, this is your second clip. Here are your clues. First one, my science teacher showed the whole class this video when teaching about genetics.
This is another Jet song, is it?
It's not a Jet song. I'm happy to pass. I can give you another clue.
I'd go another clue. Yeah.
OK, yeah. Second clue. I know many a monkey brain in my life, I can tell you.
Basement Jacks, where's your head at? That's got lots of monkeys in it. But no, it's a monkey wrench, maybe? Okay. Foo Fighters or...
Do you want to guess one of those?
Foo Fighters, monkey wrench? No, the other one, Basement Jacks.
I will give you the third clue. My younger cousin used to think the lyrics were, where's your hair,
Dad? Basement Jacks, where's your head at?
It's Basement Jacks, where's your head at? There's one point. And it looked like this.
Such a banger, the song as well.
All right, Alan, your final video comments. I love to see this video as a satire slash metaphor of all those who live for the nightlife and go to clubs slash bars with the intention to hook up slash have a good time, but they have to sacrifice slash mutilate their own essence in order to get what they want.
Oh, God.
I was going to say Rock DJ by Robbie Williams, because remember, he keeps taking everything off.
Nice and he's... one. Good.
Oh, that's good.
Ooh.
Yes. Jolly.
And it's not Bardo related.
I know, but it was on my So Fresh album under Bardo. So that's why I know it.
So you think Robbie Williams Rock DJ?
Yes.
Yes, you're right. The other comments were, I searched this as skeleton singer, lol. And heart, no Robbies were harmed during the making of this video. You got 3 points. The video looks like this.
Yeah.
And now, your love of videos in the 2000s was quite immense. Mm-hmm. Like, clearly Bardo, we know.
Yep.
Clearly a bit of Robbie Williams. Shania Twain.
Love Shania Twain. She's here. I love Shania. And I used to get called into the lounge room on a Saturday morning when she'd be on Video Hits. And they'd be like, Joel, your song's on. And I'd come running in. And I'd perform That Don't Impress Me Much, often with my own handmade leopard print outfit. And I think that is when my parents went, I think our son... it's going to go into showbiz.
All right, the end of that round, Miff, Nick, Sarah, 13 points. Ooh. Alan, Ella, Joel now in front, 16 points. Yeah. Our next round tonight is a 2000s version of the old classic Malvern Stars on 45, in which one team member powered a record player by riding a bike. This one, though, is called Fitness on Shuffle. A guest fitness fanatic will control this iPod using that cross trainer. Their team must correctly identify each song that plays. Oh. Now, to make things harder, the songs have all been downloaded at different speeds. Alan, your team is first. Would you please welcome our 2000s fitness fanatics, Kate McLennan and Kate McCartney?
Wearing. Are these some kind of like Paris Hilton hand-me-downs?
Oh, no. They smell.
They, what is that smell?
It's Rob Mills.
Rob Mills.
No good.
All right. Which one of you would like to ride first?
I tell you what, we had a look at the internet and we reckon we're going to try and do it ourselves together.
Mm.
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
Two
we're going to give it a go. We saw some twins do it
yeah.
and we reckon we can do it. All right. See you.
Oh, my God.
All right, you go.
I believe in you.
All right, I'm going to go.
Oh, one. No.
Ready? Go.
OK.
All right, here we go.
Okay, right.
All right.
This is for Alan's team.
Engage your core, mate.
I don't think I have one.
Just shout out when you know the name of it. Go. Yes, I've been
black. When I come back. Rehab by
Amy Winehouse. Correct. Next song.
I try.
Just try.
Yes, next song.
It's on your side.
Yes, I can. You're cross-watching.
God, I feel like a drag addle.
A bit faster. Straight line, silver chair. Next song.
Slow.
Oh.
MGMT.
Yes. Yes, Electric Feel MGMT. Next song.
Well done, guys.
Faster.
Faster.
A bit faster. Pass. It was beautiful Christina Aguilera. Oh my God. You got four correct. You've got to do it again for Miss Teen.
Oh my fudge.
Yeah. We hear that we're not on the panel, and now this.
All right, OK. Miff, your songs are queued up. Kate, are you ready?
Yes, I'm ready.
Right, here we go, here we go.
Okay. Amazing. Take it away, go. First song.
Are we going backwards?
No, wrong way, wrong way.
Still going backwards.
No, 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 Jess, let's get the stage.
Well, it doesn't work if you go backwards.
There we go, there we go, there we go.
What's the song though?
Seven Nation Army.
Seven Nation Army, White Stripes. Next song. Slow it down. Get the Party Started by Pink. Correct. Next song.
No, okay, okay.
Faster,
no.
Faster. Next song. Try to
kill it. Maybe slower.
Hurt by Johnny Cash, correct. Next song. Faster. Started
up. I need a beat.
Miff, Nick, Sarah, 18 points. Alan, Ella, Joel, still in front, 20 points. Yeah. Our next round tonight is called Art for Art's Sake. Teams have to identify the 2000-era musician from a piece of fan art drawn by an admirer and posted online.
Oh, God. Is there another word for that kind of art?
Is there another word for fan art?
Is it fart? Is it not fart?
Yes.
Yes. Yes. Have a look at these classic farts. If you know who they are, buzz in.
How do we buzz in?
If you don't get them straight away, I will give you a clue to help. Here is your first drawing. Myth.
That has to be Eminem.
Absolutely correct, that is Eminem.
Wow.
Oh,
wow.
Wow. Wow. I recognise that fight anyway.
All right, here's your second one. Yes, Alan's side.
Nicki Minaj.
It's Nicki Minaj.
Oh. Wow. Wow.
All right, next drawing.
What?
Is that you? Oh, no, that was Alan's side.
That's...
Wow, that's really
It came to me straight away and now it's left me almost straight away.
The tattoo is the... OK, they've got tattoos.
Oh, there's an X on his arm.
And the shade.
Henry Rollins.
Oh. It's not Henry Rollins. Do you guys want to have a guess? I've got clues.
Have you got clues? Give us some clues.
OK. It looks like it was drawn by a baby. Baby, baby, ooh. Yes.
Justin Bieber.
It is Justin Bieber.
What? Justin Bieber.
Take a dinner plate and just go, well, his head's round.
Yeah.
And the fingers.
That's right.
Yeah, the fingers. What's going on with this
I
weird...
I love the fingers.
Right, here's your next one, both teams.
Oh, gosh.
Oh. Oh.
Yes, Nick?
That's a actually better version of the real me.
That is Nick Sessa from...
Yeah.
Yes.
Oh, wow. Oh, sexy. I would watch that cartoon.
I didn't know you were in Pokemon.
carried that.
Neither did I.
That's cool.
All right, oh here is God. The next one.
Oh, it's Lady Gaga. Oh.
It is Lady Gaga.
Whoa!
It's so cool. All right, two more. Who is this? Yes.
That's me.
That is indeed Ella Hooper.
That's all you.
Hang on.
What I love is they've tried to draw hoops on your necklace. They do not look like hoops. final drawing, who is this?
Oh.
Yeah, go on.
Is it me?
No.
Oh my goodness.
I'm happy to say it is not you before first. Okay, do you want a clue?
Yes, please.
In a way, it looks like the person has been hit by a wrecking ball.
Oh, yeah. Wow.
Go on.
Miley Cyrus.
It is Miley Cyrus.
Wow. Oh, yes.
Just imagine the attic that the person would be in.
At the end of that round, the scores are Miff, Nick, Sarah on 21 points. Alan, Ella, Joel in front, 24 points. A well-known song will be performed using the words from an unrelated text. Teams have to identify the song. Nick, you'll be singing for Miff and Sarah, and you'll be taking your lyrics from Using a Computer for the First Time by Bill Hall. Yeah. That is your book. Those are your songs. Don't show your teammates. Ladies and gentlemen, Nick Sesta. Yeah. All right, song one, please.
We ready?
We're ready.
Small plastic, round-shaped device with cable and a plug attached to the plug.
It's by Gorillaz.
Yes.
The future, it's going on, let's go. And on Clint Eastwood.
Clint Eastwood is the name of the song I was looking for. Nick, song two, please.
The floppy disk is a convenient and portable form of storage to insert a disk into the drive. Push it against the hinge door and then continue to serve it all the way.
Yeah, I got it, yeah.
Yes.
A Teenage Dirtbag.
Oh, Teenage Dirtbag by Wheatus. Yes, it is.
Working hard.
Fucking good. All right, final song, please.
All right. And now you have all the foundation skills of using a computer you can go online and use. The new technology of the internet when you want it. A dollar ISP computer, establish a data connection, a data connection. And from your home computer, the modems can take care of converting on your data for use on a voice line. You will get a message back to your computer.
Yes.
Politely asking for username and password.
Yes.
Is it JT?
It's Justin Timberlake. What's the song?
What goes around? No, it's around.
Comes around. What goes around comes around. Justin Timberlake, correct. 3 points out of three. Joel, you'll be singing for Alan and Ella.
Oh.
And you'll be taking your lyrics from...
If it's Bardo, I'm going to be pissed off.
A book called The Ring Makes the Difference by Glenn Stanton.
Yes, one of my favourites.
The Hidden Consequences of Cohabitation and the Strong Benefits of Marriage. To make things fair, though, because you are a comedian and we're putting you up against a singer...
Yes.
..we have auto-tuned your microphone.
Oh. Yeah.
So if you'd like to grab that mic and just test it...
Really?
That has, yep. Have a quick... Just a safe...
Hello. Oh, hello. Hello. Oh. Oh, wow. Is it auto-tuned?
Do you believe in life after love?
Hey, Joel, I got my own auto-tune.
Okay.
If you believe in love after love...
I have... No gag reflex, so I'm not sure if that would work.
Okay, first song, please.
All right. One of the nicest things about being in a relationship has nothing at all to do with the bedroom. It's to do with bathrooms and the vacuum cleaners. You have someone who will share chores and keep the house clean. It's two married men. Oh, you bell. Okay. Sorry.
Yes?
I hope it's Bad Romance, Lady Gaga.
It's not. Hang on for a sec. I hope this doesn't come across as rude, but you were singing that, right?
Do you want the chorus?
Yes, the chorus.
Yeah. It's true, married men are more likely to help out with the chores than men who are still just living with their new girlfriend.
The vibe I'm getting is the Daleks declaring war.
Okay, we're going to turn the effect off. It's possible the auto-tune's not helping. Try it again.
It's true, married men are more likely to help out with the chores than men who... I've never done this, Alan, that helps. There's a clue.
I kissed a girl.
Thank you, Miff Warhurst!
Oh, my God. Nice one.
Joel, I would like to wholeheartedly apologise to you right now, because it turns out turning the auto-tune off did not help.
The next one's really hard.
Uh-oh.
One, I thought.
Okay, so...
Okay, hang on, I'm going to have to remember how it goes, because if I get this wrong, my whole community will kill me.
That's a hint.
Okay. Please keep this Saturday open. It's my niece's birthday. She's having her birthday party at Chunks of Cheese Pizza. Now if I want to spend my Saturdays sweating in a purple dinosaur suit, I'd work in a amusement park.
What am I doing?
Can't be good at everything, you guys.
I know this isn't in the spirit of the game, but could he sing the actual lyrics?
Okay, hang on, I'll do it again and let's see if you get it if I add something on the end, okay?
Yeah, okay.
Now, if I want to spend my Saturdays sweating in a purple dinosaur suit, I'd work in an amusement park.
It didn't help.
End of act one.
It's not Defying Gravity.
Yes, it's Defying Gravity.
On the musical Wicked.
Okay, this one, I'm going to nail this one. You ready?
Okay, yes. Final song, please, Joel.
When Reggie Mitzel, he had to learn not to respond like a bone dry sponge. He always had, had to be touching her in some way. Holding her hand, placing his hand on her knee. This sounds creepy. Having his arm around her, he need to be always touching her. As they said in the church, he needed some flesh to flesh, no matter how minimal. Not in a sexual way, more like a teddy bear or like a security blanket.
Oh, my God.
I'm pretty sure these guys might know it, but I'm going to let you have a crack first.
I'd like to hear a little bit more before we...
Okay.
I really think about the notes, not the delivery.
The notes? Oh, my
notes.
God. When Reggie Mitzel... he had to be...
Skater Boy!
It's Skater Boy by... are on 25 points, only a point behind Alan, Ella, Joel, 26 points. Teams, hands on your buzzers. 1 point for a correct answer, 1 point off for a wrong answer. There is only 1 point in it. Your questions start now. Metallica sued which peer-to-peer... Yes.
Napster.
Napster it was. English singer and model Sophie Ellis-Bextor sang about...
Murder on the dance floor.
What type of crime on the dance floor? Murder. Which group sang I'm a get you drunk? Yes.
Fergie's in it.
Black Eyed Peas. Black Eyed Peas it is. Britney Spears and Justin Timberlake made fashion history in 2001.
Oh, my favourite moment.
Denim tuxedos. Matching denim.
Double denim.
Turning up in matching outfits made entirely of what? Denim. Eminem's hit song Stan samples the music of which?
Dido.
English singer Dido. 15 years after the spaghetti incident, Guns N' Roses finally released their follow-up album. Yes.
Chinese Democracy?
Yes.
Chinese Democracy
it is. Finish these Missy Elliott lyrics. Is it worth it? Let me work it.
Put my thing down, flip it and reverse it. It's your frippin' nippers, zip, zip.
That's exactly what I was looking for. Who covered the Monkees' I'm a Believer for the movie...
Smash Mouth!
Smash Mouth for the movie Shrek, correct. What name did rapper Sean Combs release his Allen side?
Puff Daddy.
Third studio album, the cycle continues, it was P. Diddy.
No.
Your final question, what would Snoop Dogg do if he took a lasagna out of the oven with his bare hands? Smoke it.
Drop it like it's hot.
Drop it like it's hot. So, at the end of tonight's show, the final scores are... Alan, Ella, Joel ended up on 29 points. Miff, Nick, Sarah won 30 points. Would you please thank our guests for tonight? Ella Hooper, Joel Creasy, Nick Sesta and Sarah Kendall. And, of course, our two team captains, Alan Bro and Miff Warhurst. To close the show tonight, we'd like to welcome Ray Thistlethwaite with his band Thirsty Merc to play a very special arrangement of one of the defining songs of the noughties, Hey Ya by Outkast. Thanks for watching the Spicks and Specks Naughty Special. My name's Adam Hill. Good night, Australia. Nah, baby, don't mess around because you love me so and this I know for sure. But does she really want it but can't stand to see me walk out that door? Try to fight the feeling, cause the feeling alone is killing me right now. Thank God for mom and dad for sticking two together like we don't know how. You got it, oh, you think you got it, but got it, just don't get it when there's nothing at all. So why you, why you, why you, why you, why you, why you?